In the mBlock app, let's make this balloon popping game. The balloon will pop out at random positions, and with your finger you have to click the balloon. If you click it, it will pop and your score will go up by one. And when you will stop the game, you will know how many balloons appeared. In this case, total number of balloons that appeared were 21, and I was able to pop only 9 of them. So let's learn how to make this game. I have started a new project in mBlock app. First thing I'm going to do is go into this panda sprite and delete the sprite. Then I'm going to add a new sprite. I'm going to go into all, and then I'm going to select this balloon. And as you can see, this balloon has this multiple costumes symbol, which means that it has 2-3 different costumes, and hence it appears to be animated. So what we want to do is we want this balloon to appear on our stage in random locations. To do that, first we are going to go to events. We are going to bring out a when green flag clicked event trigger. And then when you go into motion, there is a block here which says go to random position. What this means is that for our balloon sprite, when the green flag is clicked, the balloon will go to a random position. So let's test out what the code we have written. So every time I press the green button, my balloon appears at a random position on the stage. So now what we want is we want the balloon to appear in random positions throughout, forever. So we go into control, and in from control we drag out this forever loop. We put the go to random position block inside the loop and we attach it to the green flag clicked. So now this command called go to random position is repeating forever. So let's test it. So when I press the green flag, my balloon is appearing at random positions on the stage. However, it's coming so fast that we can't make a game because it will be very difficult to pop this balloon. So what we have to do is we have to add a little weight. So every time it goes to a random position, it should wait, and then again go to another random position, wait, and so forth. So again in control block, we will drag out this wait command and we will put it after the go to random position loop, and it is inside the forever loop. So let's test it now. So now when I click the green flag, my balloon is appearing at random locations. So the next thing that we want to do is we want to say that whenever we click on the balloon, if we are able to successfully click on the balloon or touch the balloon with our finger, then it should pop. So for this program, what we will do is if you go to the event blocks, here we have another block which is called when this sprite is clicked, which means that if you touch this sprite with your finger on your mobile phone, then that is the event trigger here. Just like the green flag was the event trigger, now touching the sprite is an event trigger, and we are saying that if somebody touches the sprite, what should the computer do? What should the program do? So I'm saying in the sounds, I'm going to say start the sound pop. So let's test our program. I click the green flag, and whenever I click the balloon with my finger, the balloon makes a popping sound. So now it doesn't look as if, you know, the balloon has burst when we successfully click on it. So to create this effect, what we will do is we will go back to the program, and here, because we know that our balloon sprite has multiple costumes, what we can do is that we can go into looks, and from here we will drag out the next costume block, and after the wait we will put it here. So what will happen is whenever the balloon pops up at a new location, the color will be different. So that will give us the effect as if we were successfully able to pop it. So let's test this. So we are getting there, but this game is very easy to play. So to make it difficult, you can do two things. One, what you can do is reduce the weight. So I'm going to reduce the weight to just 0.5 so that the balloon is at a particular location only for half a second, and then it pops up somewhere else on the stage. So let's test this. So the game is a bit more challenging now, and if it is too challenging, you can change the timing and let me make it 0.7. The other thing you can do is if you go into the balloon sprite and if you go into parameters, you can reduce the size of the balloon. That will also make the game more difficult. So it is up to you how easy or how difficult you want to make your game. So let's test it out. So then now the game is a bit more challenging. But the thing about games is that games are fun if there is a score. If you know how many balloons appeared and how many were you able to pop. So keeping score in mBlock is very easy. And we do it with something called a variable. So first let me explain what is a variable in computer programming. In computer programming, you can think of a variable like a box in which you can store anything. So imagine that we have a box and we call this box score. And then in our game, we've got balloons. And whenever we are able to pop a balloon successfully, we get 1 point. So I pop the first balloon, I get 1 point, and I'm going to put this 1 point in this box called score. Then in our game, another balloon will appear, and if you are able to successfully pop it, again you will gain 1 point, and let me put this one also in this box called score. Then another balloon will appear, if you pop it successfully, then you will get one more point, and again let me store this point also in this box called score. So now let's say the game has ended and we ask the computer, go check what is in this box called score. So the computer will go and it will find that there in the box called score there is 1 plus 1 plus 1 which is equal to 3. So the computer will say in this box called score the total value right now is 3, and which is indeed the number of balloons that we have popped, and hence that is the score, our score for this game. So I hope that gives you a sense of what is a variable. A variable is a box and we can call the box anything. Here we called it score, and then we increment the value by 1 every time we successfully pop the balloon, and when the game ends we tell the computer to go and fetch the value of this variable or box called score. So with this understanding of variables, let's go to our programming blocks, and if you scroll down you will find variables, and within variable you will have these two options. So I'm going to choose make a variable, and I'm going to call my variable, because variable is like a box and you can call the box whatever you like. So I'm going to call it balloons popped, because that is what we are tracking, how many balloons was the player able to pop. And then I'm going to say okay, and I'm going to let it be for all sprites. I'm going to select it. So now we have this variable called balloons popped, and we have all these new programming blocks associated with this new variable. So what we want is whenever we are able to successfully pop a balloon by clicking on the sprite, the variable called balloons popped should change its value by 1. So we've got a command here which says change the variable called balloons popped by 1 whenever the sprite is clicked. So now if you want to test your program, if I start my game, every time I successfully pop my balloon, you can see that the value of this variable called balloons popped increases by 1. And when I stop the game, I know that in my game I popped 8 balloons. But saying that I scored 8 is like saying in your exams you got 8 marks, which means nothing, because you want to know what were the total marks. So did you get 8 out of 100 or 8 out of 20 or 8 out of 10? So what we also want to know to make it a bit more fun is how many balloons appeared, so that we will know that of the total number of balloons that appeared, how many balloons was the player able to pop. So to do this, to track how many balloons appeared, we have to create one more variable. So I'm going to go back into variables. I'm going to create another variable, and variable, remember, is just like a storage box, and you can call it anything you like. So I'm going to call it total balloons. I'm going to say okay for all sprites, and now we have one more variable which is called total balloons. And what we want is that whenever the costume changes, which means a new balloon has appeared, we want to increase the value of this new variable by 1, just like we were increasing the balloons popped here whenever the player successfully clicked the sprite. So I'm going to drag out this change programming block, but right now it says change the variable called balloons popped, but that is not what we want to change. What we want to change is the second variable we have created, total balloons. So if you click on the drop down, all the variables that you create will appear here, and from here you can select whichever variable is the right one. Right now we are going to say total balloons. So I'm going to put this command right inside the forever loop after next costume. So now what we are saying is that whenever a new balloon comes, increase the variable called total balloons by 1. So now if you play this game, if I start, so now whenever a new balloon appears, the total balloon variable increases by 1. And whenever a player is able to successfully pop the balloon, the balloons popped variable increases by 1. So now it makes more sense, because what you are saying is total number of balloons were 33, of which the user popped 14. But actually there is a little bit of a problem. If you notice, I have ended the game, and when I press the green flag, a new game will start. But when I press the green flag, a new game has started, but my score is still from the previous game, and that is not right. When a new game is starting, you want both of these variables to go back to zero. To do that, what we have to do is, if we go back to variable command, and here we have got a bunch of new commands here. So what we want to do is, whenever a new game starts, which means whenever the green flag is clicked and before the balloons start popping at random locations, we want to say set the variable called balloons popped, which is our score, to zero. And we also want to set the other variable, which is total number of balloons, to zero. For this, click on the drop down menu, and from here change the variable to total balloons. So now what our program is saying is that when the green flag is clicked, set both the variables balloon popped, which is the score, and total balloons to zero, and then start the forever loop. Take this sprite of balloon to a random position, wait there for 0.7 seconds, then change the costume and increase the total number of balloon variable by 1, and keep repeating this. And if the player is successfully able to click the sprite, then start the sound pop and change the score, which is being tracked by this variable called balloons popped, by 1. So right now the two variables are still have that old value from the previous game, but as soon as I click the green flag, a new game starts and both of them are reset to zero, and then balloons appearing count is here, that in this new game 9, 10, 11 number of balloons have appeared, and every time the player successfully pops a balloon, the score goes up by 1. And when we end the game, we know that in this game total number of balloons that appeared were 28, and I was able to pop, or the player was able to pop, only 4. So this is a simple game. I hope you will try making this game, and also try to make it more difficult or more easy by changing the value of weight or by changing the size of the balloon. You can also try having more balloons coming out by just duplicating the sprite. So try all these ideas, and I hope you and your friends will enjoy playing this game.